So when I look at elementary school children and I see them excited about programming, I see their eyes open and I see them dream in the way that I know I dreamed when I was a child.
Neil, I gotta say, you're totally blowing my mind right now.
That's what I do. I'm Neil deGrasse Tyson, bitch.
May I have your attention, please? May I have your attention, please? Will the real Slim Shady please stand up? I repeat, will the real Slim Shady please stand up? We're gonna have a problem here.
Y'all act like you never seen a white person before. Jaws all on the floor like Pam, like Tommy just burst in the door. They started whooping her ass first than before. They first were divorced, sewing her over furniture. It's the return of the... Oh, wait, no, wait, you're kidding. He didn't just say what I think he did he? And Dr. Dre said, nothing, you idiots. Dr. Dre's dead, he's locked in my basement. Feminist women love Eminem.
Programming that is actually fundamentally conceived for adults, but children can consume that product. And then you don't need special programs to get people interested in science, because the very news headlines are the ones doing that for you.
The universe is expanding, which means it may have had a big back then. It may have had a beginning. If it's expanded, that meant it was littler in the past. For there must have been a day when it was all together in the same place. Thus was born the Big Bang. This is just physicists burning tax money. I'm ready to...
Congress is considering pulling the plug on the James Webb Space Telescope, which is the successor...
Don't get me started.
No, I want to get you started. This is the successor to the Hubble, and they say it can peer into the universe and maybe see the moment when the universe was born. I don't even know how that happens. But it costs $6.8 billion.
Well, first of all, let's clarify what the NASA budget is. The bank bailout, that sum of money
could reach Venus.
That sum of money is greater than the entire 50-year running budget of NASA.
Wow.
And so when someone says, we don't have enough money for this space program, I'm asking, no, it's not that you don't have enough money. It's that the distribution of money that you're spending is warped in some way that you are removing the only thing that gives people something to dream about tomorrow. You remember the 60s? You remember the 60s and 70s? You didn't have to go more than a week before there's an article in Life magazine, the home of tomorrow, the city of tomorrow, transportation of tomorrow. All that ended in the 1970s. After we stopped going to the moon, it all ended. We stopped dreaming. And so I worry that decisions that Congress makes doesn't factor in the consequences of those decisions on tomorrow. Tomorrow's gone.
You know what?
They're playing for tomorrow, metaphoric tomorrow, not the literal tomorrow. They're playing for the quarterly report. They're playing for the next election cycle. And that is mortgaging the actual future of this nation. The rest of the world is the cash is bottom.
I guess I just wanted to seem interesting. I guess there's a real danger of that on this show.
There's a pressure.
People come out and they've run out of anecdotes, you know, and they just start making stuff up.
Yeah.
Like that Neil Armstrong guy. Have you seen him on the talk shows?
Neil Armstrong? You mean the first man to walk on the moon?
Talk about a fish story.
Yeah.
Man, end up buying it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
This is just physicists burning tax money.
How do we know the Earth is not flat?
We don't. It's flat.
Slim Shady and all of us. Hopkins. Let's all stand up.
all-stars.